I'm up. I'm up. Please go brush your teeth. Come here, Rex. What is that you've got? Let's see what this is.
Happy birthday, Daddy.
Isn't that beautiful? It's beautiful, Rag. Rag, hide.
Happy birthday, Daddy!
Oh, oh, stop tickling me!
Tarzan yell. I see you got your present.
Yes, you know you spent way too
much. No. Now get up, I'm fixing you breakfast.
I thought today was my day.
And I'm taking you to lunch. Let's go.
The big 4-0.
Well, the Fairview Automated Sprinkler System is now operational, thanks to yours truly.
That's great. Not bad for an old man.
Hey, watch that. Honey, that looks great.
Thank you.
I'm so hungry. Hello?
Donna. Oh, what a pleasant surprise.
Donna.
Oh, that's very kind of you to remember. Well, I can still see. I have all my teeth. My vital signs are all normal. I guess I'd have to say no. I don't feel much older.
40.
Donna, can you hold on a second? Aren't you supposed to be running off to school?
Who's Donna?
She's just a friend I've met.
Oh, you still have room in your little black book?
My new watch tells me that you are going to be late, young lady.
All right. Don't forget lunch.
Okay, I'll meet you in front of the school.
Dad, not in front.
In front?
Tell Donna I said goodbye.
Sorry, how are you? Well, I was hoping you'd call. Dinner, tonight. I'd like that. I tell you what, since you made the call, I'll make all the plans. It'll be perfect, I promise. Till then, bye.
Right. Huh. Breakfast. Can't forget about my birthday breakfast.
Let me help you with your bag.
Glad to hear it.
Thank you.
Wow. Ow! Come on!
Give me.
Hey, pal, move it, will you?
Hey, I'm sorry. Let me help you.
I can do this.
Comes a boss. Not a word about the party tonight. Just be cool, huh?
Whoa, Woogie Patrol! Hey,
whoa! Here
it
ain't.
I love it.
That's an 8-5. Whoa, honey, please! Give me a look over here. Give me a look.
Come on, huh? Yeah, I actually thought you guys might be working so hard that you'd miss one.
Not us, boss. We are men who know what we want and want what we know.
Don't you guys ever quit. In case you work up an appetite, I brought some refreshments. I need a couple of cans of paint for home.
Aren't you a little old and frail to be lifting these things?
Oh, I love it!
Whoa,
hey, baby! A bunch. My friend here just turned 40 today. Can you make him feel 20 again, huh?
Honey.
I love you guys up there. Where else in America can your IQ drop 80% and people just accept it? Look, smooth off the rough edges around those windows and paint them. I want to start taking down this scaffolding after lunch. I got a date tonight.
Whoa, Woogie Boss Man, what gives?
Hey, Neanderthal, we were introduced by a mutual civilized friend. It's our first date. So come on, let's get a move on it.
It's his problem.
Hey, Albert Einstein, the dude just turned 40 today. Male menopause. All he needs is a good time. And tonight, man, is he gonna get it. A surprise blowout party like you've never seen, huh? And this date's perfect. He goes out, we move in to set up the surprise. He'll never forget us.
Woogie Patrol!
It's not that I'm against physical fitness, you understand. It's just that a woman shouldn't run around a track and sweat like a pig and then have only the locker room to make herself presentable. You're new. You haven't seen the woman's locker room. It's like dressing in a stable. It should be illegal.
So you come here for the whole period?
Well, Nurse Crawford used to have her television in here and we would watch all my children. Oh, don't get me wrong. I mean, my complaint is valid. You're a health official. You should do something.
Here are those files you wanted.
Danny, are you all right?
I've got a problem. So do I tell him or not?
Personally, I feel the truth keeps you out of trouble. Be upfront. Be honest.
As your best friend, I'd advise against it.
Miss Thompson, you don't know my father.
Danny, if you approach someone honestly and intelligently, they understand. Trust me on this one. It'll work out.
Thanks. I'd just like to go on the record as saying the Titanic is sailing and you're on board.
Oh, come on, Stacy.
Hi.
Hi, Mr. Fairview.
Do I know you?
I'm Susan Higgins, Hal's daughter.
You're Hal Higgins' daughter?
Uh-huh.
Last time I saw... Now you... Hal's not that old. I used to play ball with Hal.
I remember.
Hi, Daddy.
Oh, hi, Danny.
Oh, hi.
Listen, say hi to your dad for me.
Sure. Bye. Ready for lunch?
Oh, hey, I'm starved.
Oh, me too. I'm
gonna curdle with my legs.
Yeah, well, that's cute. That was always fun, you know?
Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
How old? 33,
34? 34. Well, if it has to be my birthday, let's party.
Oh, Dad, don't act weird.
Hey, since this is a party, we should have party hats. One for you and one for me. Help me blow out the candle.
Dad, take that hat off now.
You used to like these hats.
Yeah, when I was 7. Not a little kid anymore.
I know. I know.
Dad, can I talk to you about something? Dad, would you stop flirting and listen to me?
Hey, I'm not flirting.
A guy asked me out.
Asked you out? You mean like on a date?
Yeah, like on a date.
Danny, I don't think that's such a good idea.
Why not?
Because you're too young. I mean, you're barely, what, 14?
Almost 16. All the girls my age go out.
Yeah, well, all the girls your age don't live at our house. Look, sweetheart, I just really don't think that you're quite ready for it yet.
You mean you're not quite ready for it?
And what is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Can we just get out of here? Check, please.
Wait a minute. Do I even know the guy?
He's just a guy from school. Not that it makes a difference. You know, Miss Thompson said that if you approach your parents honestly and intelligently, they understand. Boy, was she wrong.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing? I'll pay.
I'll pay. I'm taking you out to lunch for your 40th birthday. I am old enough to have my own money. Have to get back to school, I'll get a tardy.
Dan.
That's not my name.
All right. Maybe I am being too harsh. If you really want to go out with this guy, I guess it's okay.
Thank you, Dad.
Hey, not so fast. I mean, we gotta have a talk.
Oh, sure. Miss Thompson was right.
Miss Thompson? Who is this Miss Thompson?
Well, she's a new school nurse. Dad, you should meet her. She's kind of cute.
School nurse? No way. No, school nurse is always old and fat and smell like rubbing alcohol. I'll get my own dates, thank you. Now, about our talk.
I'll tell you everything. You're really gonna like him.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
He's just like you.
This is not just a first date. The guy dated Sally Palmer. You're batting in the big leagues. This is your chance, and you gotta be prepared.
Stacy, I don't know. I mean, she's just so beautiful.
He dumped her, didn't he? And for good reason, I'm told. Forget her, okay? I got this Cosmo survey here. If you wear a V-neck sweater or a dress with cleavage, you're basically telling him all systems are go. He'll put his arm around you, and the next move will be for you know what.
Stacy!
Now listen to me. If you want this to happen, you slowly turn to him.
Nothing wrong with what I see. You're in your prime, mister.
You know what? And when he kisses you, you let the man put his tongue in first. And you sort of melt beneath him.
Ew!
Hey, Danny, grow up. A 16-year-old woman is the object of every man's lust. And you gotta be prepared for that.
Hi! Oh, excuse me. I didn't know you were still here, Stacy. Come on, partner. Time for the afternoon special.
Dad, I don't think I want to run the day.
We run together every day. How am I going to make it up that hill without you? Come on.
What if someone sees us?
People see us all the time.
Dad,
Mr. Fairview, trust me. Running with your father would be a social faux pas of major proportions.
Okay, I'll run alone. But when I get back, I hope you will be available for that little chat we discussed.
Gotta be tough with them.
Go long. Go.
Yes!
Take it back, take it back!
Touchdown.
Oh, man, way to go.
Hey, Jack LaLanne, give it up. You're getting too old for fitness.
Well, I see you've mastered a new exercise program, Charlie.
Daughter not going with you today? She got the curse?
No. Oh, she's going out on her first date tonight.
Oh, I bet your lust buzzer is going off.
Lust buzzer? Where do you get these sayings? No. Well, my lust buzzer isn't going off.
Oh? Well, mine would be. If I had a firm young babe like her for a daughter, sending her out with a kid who's hitting his lifetime sexual peak within the next 2 days, that's when men hit it, you know. 17, 18, before they have the brains to control it. Guys like us, we're finished.
Well, you may be finished, Charlie, but not me.
You know, you should have had a son. My sons are easy. When they head out the door for a date, I tell them just one thing.
Yeah? What's that?
Get them. Get them while you're young. Use it before you lose it. You know, my eldest son just bought a van. Have you seen the vans these days? He calls it his love den.
Love den?
Stereos, beds, condoms. The kid is 17. What a life. We were born too soon, Bill. Bill! Bill!
Tress, that's the main thing. All guys aren't like that. I'm sure this kid is fine. Yes, if I can control myself, I'm sure he can too.
What are you looking at? You've been fixed. I'm gonna have to lay down some heavy rules.
We need to talk. So tell me about this Mr. Wonderful of yours.
He's not Mr. Wonderful. His name is Jim Parker. Dad, he is so cute.
What makes him so cute?
I don't know. He has a nice body.
A nice body? Danny, honey, that's not how you pick someone. A body is just a shallow hunk of skin. What's going on in his mind? That's what you want to know. Is he understanding? Is he sensitive? Tell me more.
Well, he's a senior. He's 6 foot.
A senior? 2 years older? 6 foot? What is he, a mutant?
That's not that big, Dad. He's only a little bit taller than you. He's captain of the football team.
Oh, I was captain of the football team.
I know, I know. You are the champs. 8-3. Boy, Cleveland High had a team then.
Very funny, very funny. Go on.
Well, that's it. Basically, he's major league.
I mean, that's all you know about this guy? 6 foot, a senior? I get more history than that from a centerfold bio.
Gross. You read that stuff?
No, but if I did, I would. Don't change the subject.
You're twisting Mr. Pipster's head off.
Oh. So, where is Mr. Football taking you?
Well, first we're going to a party at the marina, and then we're going to a movie.
The marina? Whose party?
Well, some guy's school's father has a boat. There'll be lots of people there, and we won't stay long.
I don't like boats. You be sure there are life preservers on board, and nobody named Gilligan.
Ha ha. We're not even leaving the dock.
Which movie?
I don't know. The one at the Avenue. I didn't ask. I didn't know you were going to prosecute me. And then we're going to a dance at school.
A party, a movie, and a dance? Don't you think that's quite a bit for a first date?
What is wrong, Dad? Don't you trust me?
Of course I trust you. Now let's talk about some rules.
Rules?
All right, if you don't like the word rules, think of them as commandments. Yes, the 10 commandments of dating. I'm God, you're Moses.
I hate this already.
You might want to get some granite tablets to chisel these in. Number one, thou shalt not go out with any boys you haven't brought before me. Now, you've already cleared this guy, so we're fine there. I'll meet him tonight, give my final approval. Number two, thou shalt not drink any alcohol of any kind.
Dad, you know me better than that!
Right. Right. Okay. Number three, never get into a car with anyone who has been drinking. Number four, thou shalt always carry enough money to be able to get a cab home in case things go bad. Number five, use your head. Avoid potentially dangerous areas. Number six, if there is a confrontation, get out of there. Don't let boyfriend Jim try to be a hero. Number seven, thou shalt not do anything that will result in me getting a call from the police saying that you were being detained.
Oh, come on, Daddy, I'm not a criminal.
Number eight, don't be afraid to call me for help. I'm here for you. Number nine, and most important, thou shalt be home by midnight and not a second later.
Midnight? Come on, Daddy, nobody has to be home that early. Besides, I'm staying at Stacy's.
No. He picks you up here, he brings you back here by midnight. In fact, I'm gonna program my Data Master trash compactor to let me know when you should be home.
So what's number 10?
Number 10 is, I haven't thought of number 10 yet. Thou shalt leave room for any other commandments I might think are necessary.
Figures.
Danny, these rules are for your safety, not mine.
If you're done, can I please have some privacy?
Sure, sure. By the way, that's a nifty outfit. Now, if I were a young man coming to take you out and saw you, I would know right from the start the type of good girl I was dealing with. You know, you're still my special girl.
Goodbye, Dad.
All right.
Hello? Stacy, you won't believe what just happened. My father told me I look like a good girl. This outfit is history. I need your help.
Take my daughter out? Probably expecting some wimp. Hi, I'm Danny's dad. They call me Dr. Destroyer. Yeah. I'm gonna touch her and die. You fix it, farmer! Oh, what am I getting so upset about? It's all just a normal part of growing up. I can trust.
Hey, Muhammad Ali. Your daughter tell you who the guy is yet?
My daughter doesn't go out with just any guy. I checked him out. He happens to be the captain of the football team.
Jim Parker?
Yeah, you know him?
The kid's a stud.
The kid is too young to be a stud, okay?
If you say so. But you know, this girl was born in 1971. Boy, talk about feeling old. Nice hiney.
Besides, I've set up some ground rules. Protect her from trouble. Same rules my parents gave me.
And you followed those rules?
Danny's a girl. Girls follow rules.
You've been dating the wrong girls, pal.
Well, if nothing else, Charlie, I've laid down the curfew law. I told her she absolutely, positively must be home by midnight.
That's good.
That's exactly what I tell my kid. Home by midnight, back by one. Go get him, champ.
My name is Jim Parker, sir. May I come in, sir?
What?
I said, may I come in, sir?
You can't go out till you come in, Jim.
Well, that's a great stereo, sir.
Yeah, I rocked it. Roll in my day. My generation invented it, you know.
Yeah, that's a great dog, too.
He's mean as a snake and very protective of Danny. You can call me Mr. Fairview, Jim. What's formalities between two Cleveland High School football captains?
You were a captain at Cleveland, sir?
You bet. We were 8-3 both years. Cleveland had a darn good team back then. How's your squad?
Undefeated. It looks like you kept in pretty good shape, sir.
Take a punch.
Oh, no, I couldn't.
Come on! You don't want your date's father to think you're Tinkerbell, do you? Now, come on, take your best shot.
Whoa, that's pretty solid, sir. I wish my dad had stayed in shape like that. He's in the hospital. He had a heart attack.
I'm sorry. An older man?
Yep.
Well, he's probably done plenty in his life. He's just reached an age where it's time for him to slow down.
Yeah, he's 41. Is Danielle ready?
Danielle?
Wow.
Hi.
Gee, you look great.
Thank you.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
Mr. Fairview, it was very nice meeting you.
Dad, Jim is talking to you. Dad? Let's just get out of here.
No! Hey! Wait a minute! Hold it right there, hotshot. What's a big idea taking my daughter out in that love den? Huh? Commandment 10, no vans.
Mr. Fairview, my car's in the shop.
I don't care. You're not taking her out in that.
Dad!
Well, you can use my car. Here. Here are the keys.
Yes, sir.
Hey, hey, give me the keys to the van. I don't want you sneaking back here to get it.
Yes, sir.
And you be careful.
Yes, sir.
And have her home by midnight. Hello?
Hi. I'll be out in a second.
Oh, take your time. By the way, you mind if we take your car? My car's in the shop, and I got this loaner.
Oh, that's fine. Why don't you have a seat? I am so sorry about not being ready on time.
Hey, look, don't rush. I'm cool.
And so, the great majority of all rape crimes in the United States are committed by men who the victim knows. The boy down the street who takes out the girl next door, buys her dinner, and then feels he is owed something. Unfortunately, it's quite common, and it's called date rape. sometimes an innocent...
No. No. Well, I'm not letting her out of my sight. Everywhere she goes, I'm there. I'll kill him if he touches her. I will kill him!
Bill, are you all right?
Huh? Well, oh, yeah. Yeah. Just these damn date rapists. You know, somebody ought to take these perverts and just teach them a lesson. Hi.
Happy birthday.
Thanks.
So how old are you?
34.
Happy 34. Where does this perfect evening you plan for me begin?
I know this great place, near the marina.
Sounds terrific.
You okay?
Look, if you don't want to go out with me, I understand.
Why would you say that?
My father was so uncool.
I don't know. He let us borrow this car.
He only did that because the idea of a van scared him to death. I don't want you to feel like you're stuck with me and my father's stupid rules.
Danny, don't feel you're alone. My father's easily as bad as yours.
Hard to believe.
Oh, really? 2 years ago at the father-son sports dinner, my father bought baby pictures of me to show the coach that I was a natural-born player. But that wasn't enough. He showed it to the cheerleaders, my friends, you name it. Everybody saw me bare-butt carrying a football.
I bet it was cute.
Oh, yeah, it was darling. I could have killed him. Does the radio work?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Good evening, ma'am.
Here's your ticket, sir.
Oh, Bill, this is beautiful.
Huh? Oh, thought you'd like it.
Right this way.
Thank you. Aren't boats wonderful?
Hmm? Oh, yes, yes, I love boats. I could watch them for hours. You know, I've always had a dream about sailing around the world or something.
Oh, Bill, you should. You're only 34.
Mm-hmm.
You have no family obligations.
Mm-hmm.
You should go for it.
Maybe someday I will.
I'll be back. Jim!
I'm so glad you're here.
Sally, you made it. That's great.
Don't look at me, pal. I didn't invite her.
Don't you just love this boat?
Yeah, it's great.
Have you been downstairs? It's so cool. Dave said that it's 10, but 20 is just as easy, get it? Come on, you've got to see it.
Not right now, Sally.
Danny won't mind. Danny, you don't mind if I steal Jim for a moment, do you?
Guys, we need some ice.
Oh, we'll get it.
You sure?
No problem.
Come on, Dad. All right. Machine's on the ramp there. Thanks.
Thank you. Excuse us.
Are we ready to order?
Yes. The lady will have the Lapin Bourguignon with watercress Vichy Soise.
Excellent choice. And for you, sir?
I'll have the New York stud.
A steak.
Very good.
And an appetizer. Pâté maison, escargot, soufflé?
Yes, and French fries.
We will not serve French fries. Potatoes au gratin, scalloped gratin dauphinois.
Fine. And screen the pea soup elegant. Dollar tornado salad. Broccoli Dijonnaise. Chocolate mousse. What kind of restaurant do you run here? Do you give all your customers trick chairs? Bring me another this instant. You really gotta watch these people. Now, where were we?
Yee! Party time!
Boogie!
Got the women?
Have I got the women? Bill's gonna go nuts!
We're gonna go nuts!
Looks like they're having fun.
It's a little rowdy.
Oh, they're kids. It's a party. That's what they're supposed to do.
I think it would be wonderful to have kids someday.
Yeah, 10 boys. 10 huge boys.
Water is so sensual.
Yes.
Rippling waters, pounding, thrashing, sometimes caressing.
No! I mean, well, I never really thought of it like that. When I think of water, I think of baptism, purification of the flesh, spirituality, you know?
Purification of the flesh?
Mm-hmm.
Bill, are you all right?
I'm sorry. Would you excuse me for a moment?
You're not feeling well, are you? Listen, why don't you go freshen up some?
I will. I'll be right back.
Great party, man. We got a jam, though. The movie starts soon. I want to keep things cool with Danny.
Understandable. Hey, I'm sorry about Sally Shawn. I didn't know. But Danny, she is hot for a sophomore, pal. You have fun.
All right, man. Hey, guys. Everyone that thinks that Danny Fairview's got the best south side in the sophomore class, say arr!
Arr!
Madam, will the gentleman be returning?
He's feeling a little under the weather. I think he went to splash some water on his face. Thank you.
Still not back?
Would you please check the restroom?
I feel refreshed now.
I've never heard of such a thing. So the faucet just blew up in your hand?
Isn't that crazy? I mean, and then the whole sprinkler system went off. I mean, I was just sitting there and suddenly it's Niagara Falls.
So, Jacques Cousteau. You sure you don't want to go home and change your clothes? I really don't mind.
Oh, you are beautiful. I promised you a perfect night. I'm not going to let a little damp clothing get in the way.
Best.
Oh, I don't know. I think Bobby Brown is pretty good, too.
If you were on a desert island and you could only have one record, which would it be?
What?
I like to torture myself with these little fantasies.
Pat Boone.
Pat Boone?
What's the matter? Don't you like milk?
It's starting. Bill, it's lovely. Thank you.
What is so funny?
That outfit. It makes me laugh.
Yeah?
You don't know how special that is. You know, if you don't mind me saying, you're not like most of the men I've known.
Two for the 9 o'clock. How many men have you known?
Oh, I mean that in a good way, Bill. This evening you've planned, the dinner, the flower, it's also very sweet. You know, I gotta tell you, I was a little apprehensive about giving you a call, but I am so glad I did. You're quite the romantic. And nothing ever shames you. You're never embarrassed.
Does a classic movie keep me in the romantic category?
Bill, I love classic movies. Humphrey Bogart and Katharine Hepburn in African Queen. I cried for days after I saw Love Story.
So did I.
Bill, did you really? That is so beautiful. So few men let down their emotional walls. So, what are we gonna see? Oh, no, 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 don't tell me. I want to be surprised. I can't see.
I can.
Excuse me. I know some people consider these movies classics, but I must warn you, they do affect me. We're leaving?
Better seats.
Excuse me.
Excuse us. It's so dark in here.
That's the idea. You see, the director has chosen to show us the girl's peril by showing us what she sees. Right now, the killer has her blindfolded so we don't see nothing. Listen. Hear that? The psycho started up the edge tremors. You can hear it, but you can't see it. Great effect, huh? Great director. A minute later and you would have missed that.
Let's go. In the van. Come on, get in the van quick. Oh, yes. Yes, you're beautiful. Oh, happy. Come on, let's go.
Oh, sick. What's he doing now?
The killer, Johnny Iota. His problem lies in the fact that he watched too much professional bowling as a child. After he chops their heads off, he takes the girls to a deserted bowling alley. He props up their headless bodies in the chairs and pulls with their heads. Watch!
Right!
No!
Wait till you see him get the 7-10 split!
Hey, shut up!
Blow off, pal!
Come on, let's get the girls in the house. Lovely.
God, this is nice! I've always wanted to live in a place like this. And so father knows best, you know? Where's your boss?
He'll be here soon.
I'm going to show him a real good time.
We entered this house to make party history. Let's be sure we give him one he'll never forget. Let's go!
This scene's not so bad.
Donnie, you're cutting off the circulation in my leg.
You can grab mine.
Get your hands off of her! I said get your hands off of her now!
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Your history, pal!
I'm sorry.
Get that sicko out of here.
Need a ride home?
It was all just a misunderstanding. If you knew the kind of day I had, look, we'll just leave and get out of your hair.
I think that would be a good idea.
So, Godzilla, when are you going to fill me in and what's going on?
In a minute. Let's just get out of here.
Avenue 2? This one.
I am so hungry now.
Hey! This is not an official exit! I think the car's this way.
Bill, hold it. Will you tell me what's going on? Now, I know how those movies affect me, but ranging down the aisle like Attila the Hun came out of left field. Oh, gross. Two old people making out in an alley.
Yeah, let's go around.
Well, you're a passionate soul. That wasn't quite... explanation. It was a good first line, but that was no explanation.
I'm sorry. I guess to someone who doesn't know a history of this theater, this all must seem very strange.
To say the least.
A few years ago, a rash of crimes took place. A man, a very sick man, was doing some very bad things to young women in that theater. It went on for months. 15 girls were victimized.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, did they ever catch him?
Yes. They got his fingerprints off a greasy popcorn box. Yeah. I got called for jury duty at the trial. Weeks and weeks of the worst testimony and evidence you can imagine. We got him, but, you know, just as they were taking him away, he turned to us, and I'll never forget it. He said, "See you at the movies." Since then, I've had a lot of problems with that theater.
Bill... I had no idea. What an awful experience. Why would you want to take me back there?
You have to face your fears.
You made me feel as though I was capable of doing that. I guess I'm not quite ready.
Bill, it was a great effort. You can do it. I know you can. So let's just put this silly episode behind us and go on.
I know a place that you'll love.
What's wrong with this place? I like you. Didn't your daddy ever tell you it's dangerous to walk in alleys?
Look, fella, the lady and I are just going to our car, so kindly get out of the way.
Or you'll do what?
Bill?
No, Donna. This I can handle. But first, I'd knock your brains out, but I can't knock out what you don't have, so I guess I'd just have to kick your butt. Of course, in your case, I'd have to figure out which end that is. Now, if you still want to get into this, you need to know that my hands are registered, and I'll tear you limb from limb. Yeah? Fellas, let's just forget this. I don't need two murders on my hands.
My father told me to avoid things like that. Let the police handle it, okay?
Sure.
Oh, wow. Oh, God, they maced you in the eyes. Let me see. Yeah. Just keep them shut. Come on, follow me. Careful.
Sure you're all right?
Oh, absolutely. We won't let a little mace ruin the evening.
Maybe you should let me drive.
Oh, what? And ruin the surprise? No way. Cleveland High School. I used to go here. I think it's really important for people to not only get to know about people they're seeing, but they should experience their roots as well.
Gee, Bill, what's next? Your maternity ward?
I hope that won't be necessary. But I just want to show you around my old stomping ground so you can get a better feel for me as a person. Romantic, huh?
I guess, but I have a pretty good feel for the school already.
Well, yeah, how's that?
I'm the school nurse.
Oh, I know another place.
Oh, Bill!
I'm okay. Why don't we just go now?
No. I'm going to take you to my office and look in those eyes. I insist.
Oh, come on, Donna.
Bill?
I'm really fine.
Shh.
Look, we don't have to.
Watch out for the step.
What step? Oh. Come on, forget the roof.
Bill.
I'm fine.
Don't
really
argue with me, Bill. All right, Bill. I want you to follow me.
Ow! That is bright.
I told you to keep your eyes covered. Now just follow me over here. I'm gonna get a light so I can look in your eyes, all right?
Well, no. Look, you don't have to. It's all right.
Stay still.
Ah!
Oh, I'm sorry. Why'd you tell me you're all right? That wasn't your normal everyday mace, you know. I make that stuff myself.
Great. What'd you put in it? Nuclear waste?
Cafeteria food. We're gonna flush out your eyes. Come over here to sink. Do you want me to wash them for you?
No, but you can give me a sponge bath.
Wash. Towel. All right. I'm going to come over here. There's a cot in this room. I want you to lay down. So just follow me.
Yeah.
Oh, Bill, are you okay?
Never felt a thing.
All right. Come on. Right down here. Lay right down there. Good. Put your legs up there. All right. Oh. Look, I want to put a wet washcloth on these eyes.
Could you kiss them and make them better?
I'll go get that washcloth. And maybe one for myself.
Okay, so between the movie, popcorn, and dance, he's already spent about 25 or 30 bucks. Not bad, considering the evening isn't over. But certainly not so much that he should expect anything, if you know what I mean. Now, did he go for you in the movie?
No, he just held my hand.
Did he grab your tush at the party or anything like that?
No, Stacy, he's been a perfect gentleman.
Yeah, that's what worries me. High school men aren't known for being gentlemen. He either really likes you or he's gonna dump on you.
Well, there is one thing that's kinda...
Kinda what? Kinda what?
I don't know. Probably nothing.
So if it's nothing, you tell me, and it's still nothing. For God's sakes, we're in this together. What is it?
Well, I think he might still be hung up on Sally Palmer. No, I'm serious. Everywhere we go, she's there. And when he sees her, he looks kind of sad.
Sally Palmer is just a walking sex machine. I hope that perfect face of hers sags to her navel by age 25. I mean, you are such a better person than she is. I'm going to go check out this new development. I'll get back to you. My ear is to the ground.
You know, this place still smells like it did when I went here. Like rubbing alcohol. It's a smell you never forget. Well, that feels good.
If you just turned 34, that means you graduated when? 17, 18 years ago?
Something like that.
Hmm.
Hey, where are you going?
I'm gonna look you up. We have all the old yearbooks here.
Oh. Hey, Donna, come here. This washcloth is dripping all over me. Could you give me a paper towel, please?
Sure. Huh. That's funny. We had a whole supply of them this morning. You stay put. I'll go get you some.
Thanks.
Serve a purpose.
Which is?
Driving Jim crazy.
Did you see that girl Jim brought to the dance? What is she, a sophomore?
If he's trying to make me jealous, I'm not impressed.
Is that what you think he's trying to do?
Jim's angry I went out with Tommy, so he finds this hard-up little sophomore, asks her out on a date, and thinks he's teaching me a lesson.
And what are you gonna do?
Have a great time with Tommy till Jim comes crawling back.
You don't think there's a chance that he might actually like this girl, do you?
Please.
Yearbooks. Yearbooks. Where are they? Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. No, no, no. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's good. That's good. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's good. That's good. Good. Yes, yes.
Hello? Hello? Are you okay in there?
I'm fine.
Is there anything I can do for you?
No, really, I'm okay.
Well, why don't you come on out here?
No, I'm all right.
I want to see for myself. Oh, Danny, what's wrong? What is it? Just sit at that chair for a minute. I'll be right back. Feeling a little better?
Oh, yes.
Why don't you rest a little while longer? I have a minor crisis with a student.
What's the problem?
She just needs a woman-to-woman talk. I'll be right back. So you said this girl told her friend that Jim was just using you?
She said he was just going out with some hard-up sophomore to make her jealous.
You don't believe that, do you?
I don't know. Look at us. She's so gorgeous. I'm sure she knows about a lot of stuff I don't even have a clue about.
Oh, Danny, I wouldn't worry about that. That doesn't make her any better than you.
Sex options. They're selling it like bucket seats.
You mean sex stuff? What do you want to know? I'll tell you.
Well, it's not so much the facts as it is...
the experience?
Yeah. Well, look at the girls he's gone out with. I'm sure he's done stuff with them.
Maybe not. He might not want that at all.
I thought all men wanted it.
No. Danny, what would make you say something like that? That's nothing. Go ahead.
Well, ever since my mother died, my father, he watches women. Everywhere we go, he looks at them, and I guess I just figured that if my 40-year-old father is that way, aren't most men?
No, Danny. In fact, the guy I'm out with tonight is not like that at all. Listen, honey, I think this girl you overheard tonight wasn't a very reliable source. Jim hasn't done anything to make you not trust him, has he?
No.
Never put up with a lying man, Danny.
But don't be so quick to jump to conclusions either. If he is lying, wouldn't it be better to hear from his own lips than from some overwrought skeezer? And experience? Honey, that'll just come with time. Dating should be fun and exciting. Enjoy it.
I really want him to like me, what there is.
Will you stop knocking yourself? You've got a lot going for you. Go get him.
You really think so?
You don't believe me? We'll get a man's opinion. My date is in the other room. You want to meet him? And Danny, about this first date, it's bound to be nerve-wracking. It'll get easier. Danny, this is...
High school nurse that talks girls into it.
To water.
When I look at you, I feel things inside that I've never felt before. Thank you.
Want a shot, dude?
No, thanks.
Hey, you gonna sit up here with us? You gotta do our thing. You look pretty wasted already. Come on.
What is this?
I made it in chemistry class. You know, education has its benefits. Hey, Rudy, you want a shot? He always has the best time of anybody at these things. Why are they playing this garbage? Hey! Hey! Play some Zeppelin! You want another shot?
Will you shut up? And I say to you, this is a night to dream.
And your makeup are perfect.
You're a living knockout. Who does your color chart?
Stacy, I've lost my date. Have you seen a man in a waiter's jacket?
You're out with a waiter? Miss Thompson, I hope you don't mind me saying, but a woman like you could do better.
It's a long story, Stacy.
Hey, check out that chick in the blue miniskirt.
Shh, shh, shh.
That's the new school nurse.
I know, I know.
Hey, nurse, I need a hernia operation.
Wanna dance, Jimmy?
It's time to rock and roll, Cleveland High! Turn the lights, we wanna see everybody! Come on!
He's really a nice guy.
Oh my God, that man over there!
What man?
That man, it's Mr. Fairview!
You know that man?
Know him, he's Danny's father. I've got volumes on that guy.
Stacy, give it all to me.
Oh, when they put that wall here.
Oh, oh. Liar!
Donna, I...
Shut up! How could you lie to me like that? I'll plan the perfect evening, Donna. I know this beautiful spot at the marina, Donna.
It was nice, wasn't it?
I opened up to you, Bill. I trusted you. And you just fed me a line from one end to the other. I want 10 huge boys, Donna. My Corvette's in the shop, Donna. All this so you could follow your daughter around like she was some sort of criminal.
But that wasn't why I did it. It just ended up that way. And how about you in the office, huh? Telling her that men don't think that way. Have you lost your mind? Morning, noon, and night, I guarantee you that kid's only thinking about one thing, which will be much easier for him to get thanks to you. Go get him, Danny. Thanks a lot.
That's not what I meant. But if you took it that way, you're even sicker than I thought. If your daughter's old enough to date, she's old enough to be trusted. Although I don't know why I'm telling you this. You can't be trusted in your 40. Oh, yeah. I know how old you are. Did you think I was so shallow that I wouldn't want to go out with you if you were old enough to have a 15-year-old daughter? Or are you that vain?
Donna, I don't think a nurse should act that way.
Don't try to weasel your way out of this one with some boyish looks and charms, you! Liar!
Donna.
Don't say it! I don't want to hear it! You know what's really sad, Bill? I liked you. Not the 34-year-old, not the pseudo-sophisticate. Just the average old Bill. If that's even your name.
Donna.
I don't know about the fast one, but the slow.
You know, you really dance well.
No, I don't.
No, yes, you do.
Here it is. That's him, number 9. That is my father.
All parents look like that back then.
Listen, Danny, can I talk to you for a second?
Sure.
I want to apologize about Sally.
Oh, no, that's not your fault.
Well, it's just that we went out for a long time, and it's kind of hard to make a clean break, you know? I don't want to hurt anybody.
I get the feeling the only thing that could hurt her is a silver bullet. So tell me, where do I fit in?
I like you, Danny. A lot. I mean, you're pretty. You're sensitive. You're sweet. I don't want you to think that Sally has anything to do with us, or that anything between you and I is less than honest. I like you, and I want to prove it. Okay, what do you say we get out of here? Go someplace where we can be alone and not be bugged.
Okay, where to?
The Bailey Hotel. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, let's go.
You little punk, you take my daughter to that hotel and you'll burn in hell! Hey, somebody, anybody let me out of here!
Oh, man, my locker's been possessed by the devil. You butthead devils, can you just get out of my locker?
Open the door!
Look, there's no way, Jose. Now I've read about this action. I let you out, and then you're just gonna want to take over the whole world.
I'm not a demon. I'm a father!
Oh, yeah. Nice try. God, my locker is like a gate to the underworld.
Let's make a deal.
I've heard about your deals, man.
You open the door, and I'll get you an A in shop. Have all your detentions erased. Have Barry Manilow possessed. And I'll turn Vice Principal Downey into a tennis ball.
Make it a frog? You know, so I can dissect him in biology?
Fine, anything else?
Well, can I get, like, all the Motley Crue's chicks?
Done. Now open up.
No, I really can't.
Whoa, wow, look at all this junk food in here.
My Twinkies! No, 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 don't eat my Twinkies! Don't...
Don't mess with the devil, kid.
Hotel. Oh, doesn't this thing move any faster?
Hey, we in this life must prepare for the serenity of the great beyond by practicing patience. Patience, principle, trust. These are the essences of our happiness and our existence.
Look, Haji, my daughter is about to be pillaged by Jabba the Hutt. $50 if you get me there in 5 minutes.
Hey, hang on, buddy.
Sally, what are you doing here?
Jimmy, I didn't know you were here.
Listen, Danny and I came here to be alone.
Don't tell me you've got a room with her. What are you gonna do, read her a bedtime story?
Yeah, we got a room.
We got room 320 to be exact. Now, if that's a problem, you have to deal with it on your own. Because this is over, do you understand?
Don't count on it. Nobody does this to me. Especially a little twit sophomore.
$50.
Yeah. Listen, Haji, remember what you said about how patience and trust will prepare you for the afterlife?
Mm-hmm.
Hold that thought.
Hey, $50. Come back. $50.
Please, I'm looking for my daughter. She came in about 10 minutes ago with her boyfriend, young couple.
Young couple. Big fella. Stud.
That's him, Jim Parker.
Hot looking girl. Dress cut up to her cheeks. Firm thigh.
Oh, my God. Where are they?
They were here, but I couldn't tell you where they went.
Oh.
Excuse me. Did I hear you say you were Danny Fairview's dad?
Yes.
Is she in some sort of trouble?
She will be when I get a hold of her. I'm going to put her in the basement with a chastity belt and a pit bull. She'll be grounded for life.
Oh, I wouldn't want her to get into any trouble. But I did see her here with Jim Parker, who does have a reputation of getting girls to this hotel. He even brags about his favorite room, 320. I wouldn't want anything to happen to Danny that she would be sorry for.
320, you've been a big help.
Oh, when you do find Danny, would you please tell her that Sally Palmer says hi?
Yeah. Excuse me. There he is.
Please,
please,
Doc, this way.
Huh? Huh? There he goes. Keep before the door closes. Come on.
Is this your first time?
Yeah.
Are you ready for it now?
God, yes. I'm ready.
Oh. Run! Heal this woman.
Thank you,
Wake
Lord.
Wake up to the truth. I am reminded.
Is this room 320? Didn't you order a side of beef? What are you doing?
Come to Mama, pretty boy. It's time for you to repent.
I think this is a mistake.
He's got to be here. Let's go. Come on.
On, sweet cheeks.
No,
repent
please.
With me.
No.
Would you look like a man who knows what he wants and wants what he knows?
What did you say?
No! Help! He broke into my room and tried to have his way with me.
What?
I was defenseless.
That's not true.
He tried to deflower me. Arrest him.
No.
Take that monster away.
No, I didn't. Come on, man. She's lying. She attacked me.
A woman's not safe in this hotel.
I tell you, my daughter's in that hotel. She's only 15. You got to believe me. Officer, at least go check. There's a crime going on there. Oh.
Roger 22. That's affirmative. Unit 17, repeat.
Danny, what is it?
My father's rules have me so freaked out, I'm starting to see things.
10-20 in progress.
What? You never call me anymore, huh? Oh! Debbie, the divorce was last week, wasn't it? You two out of it, yeah?
Hey, it's almost 11. What do you think's keeping him?
I don't know. I say if he's not back soon, we'll start the party without him.
Woogie Patrol! Woogie!
Hey, don't I get a phone call?
Yeah, you get a call.
Look, I was only concerned about my daughter's well-being. I was just trying to be a good father. Why won't you listen to me? I don't belong in here. I didn't do anything. Hey, the chief is a friend of mine, you know.
Children are the root of all evil. You spend time with them, you help them, and then one day they come at you with, I want a car, a phone, a dress, more money, more freedom. We can change that. You and me, we're bonded. We can stop those little SOBs before they get us. We're bonded. We're men on a mission.
Guard!
What is this?
Oh, my. Oh, go for it. Oh, oh, yes. How sweet it is. Oh, shake it. You sweet young love. Catch it. Yeah.
Come on, move it ahead.
Hey, I'm going.
Move.
I don't know where everybody could be. Isn't the chief here?
Nope.
Hi, it's Bill. Yes, that's my real name. Listen.
I'm sorry about tonight. I'm sorry I lied to you. It was Danny's first date, and I panicked. You were right. She is capable of taking care of herself, of making the right choices. And she deserves more than a father who can't.
I know you probably won't believe me, but I really like you. I did lie to you about my age. I'm sorry. At the time, it seemed harmless. I was wrong.
Got that one right, bozo.
I just didn't think it would lead to this. Anyway, my time is running out, and I have a favor to ask.
I knew it!
Even though I know I don't deserve it.
I'm in a bit of a tough situation. I'm in jail.
What?
That's right.
In jail. Look, it's 11:15. If you get this message, if you could please just go to my house and be there when Danny gets home at midnight.
I'd be in your debt forever.
I think somebody ought to be there for her. And it's obvious it can't be me. I'm sorry.
Look, we've got a lack of communication. Ladies, let's go. Please, can you sit down? Look, we're talking about a lack of communication. Hey, Charles. Yeah. Give me a cup of coffee, will you? I got it.
Thank God you're here.
That'll be all, officer. Hang on a second, will you, Bill? I'm just finishing going over some evidence. We're getting ready to bust a big porno operation. Gotta constantly keep checking the evidence, you know what I mean? Oh. How they can twist themselves into all those positions, I'll never know. Want to take a look?
No. Charlie, can I get out of here? Danny's due home in half an hour. I should be there.
I would think you should. Now, here's your arrest report.
Charlie. Charlie.
Bill, this 500.
My wallet was stolen. You know that.
Hey, I'm sworn to uphold the law. I can't do a thing or the judge would have my behungers.
Well, can you loan me the money? You know I'm good for it.
You have a wild, raunchy party right across the street from me. You don't invite me, but you get busted and expect old Charlie to bail you out.
What are you talking about? What party?
Come on, guy. There's been a steady stream of booze and broads through your house all night. And I'm going to have some great pictures of it by morning. Your whole crew is there and some nasty-looking female flesh. Wild.
Charlie! Man, it's almost 11:30. It's my birthday. The guys probably just threw me a surprise birthday party. Please, believe me, if I threw a raunchy party, you would be the first one I'd ask.
Yeah?
Absolutely. Now, do me a favor. Bail me out, huh? I gotta get home and clear that place out before Danny walks into the middle of all of that. Will you do that for me? Somebody help me! Help! 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 Please, somebody help! Help! Oh, thank you! Oh, thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Oh, thank you! You saved my life.
Buckle up, Satan. I'm taking you back to hell.
Take it easy!
Don't talk to me, Satan. I never should have let you out of your cage. I'm taking you to the cliffs outside of town, and I'm driving you off them. I brought you into this world, and now I'm gonna take you out.
Watch out! I'm not Satan!
How stupid do you think I am, huh? Look at this album cover. Look, I know how you plan to come into the world and ruin everything that's good for it, but you can forget it. I have moral values, you know.
You do?
Yeah.
You ever put a car in reverse at 60 miles an hour? Officer, I'm Father Fairview, and that intoxicated devil worshiper kidnapped me, dressed me like Satan, and was attempting to brainwash me with rock and roll music when the Lord himself caused the transmission to fall from its mountings.
A drunk driver, huh?
Yes, yes.
Okay, Father, why don't you take a seat in the patrol car, and I'll handle this.
Oh, bless you.
About something we can talk.
And this is the army, you know.
Boss. Boss. Boss, talk to me, would you?
Earlier tonight, I gave my daughter 10 rules to follow in order to have a safe and sane night out. I have broken all but one of those rules. In 20, 19 minutes,
my 15-year-old daughter will be coming home with her date. And when she gets here, she's going to find her dear old dependable dad alone in a clean house, waiting for her, just like Robert Young. I love you all. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Now please, start cleaning up this place.
Before I start killing people!
Oh no, it scratched. I bet it was that car we saw racing out of the lot.
My dad will absolutely freak.
Yeah, she'll be late. Teenagers are always late. Come on, fast. Fast, please.
It'll be okay.
I hope so.
Move it, buddy.
Screen.
Look at this place. It's all to heaven.
Unit 18. Unit 18.
Stay out here. Keep an eye on things. You come with me.
Yes, sir.
Got your camera?
Here's a present from your local police.
My wallet. You found the guys. That's great, Charlie.
Listen, you can take this whole party over to your house. You can have anything you want. I don't care. Just don't arrest me for taking that patrol car.
Don't sweat it. I've been wanting to put that heavy metal punk in jail for a long time.
You put him in jail?
Come on, man. Chill, buddy. Look, let me tell you something. The guy wrecked my car. Hey, look, man. Hey, wait. Look, I'm only 17!
A teenager? Who's there? A man with a mission.
Dad?
Son?
Ooh, scratching the door is nothing. How'd you like to be the guy who did that?
That's it, boss. I think we got it all.
Oh, good. Thank you very much.
Hey, you know, we're really sorry if we screwed things up for you.
Hey, look, forget it. It was a nice thought. It just came at a bad time. I'll see you guys Monday.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi.
I guess we saved you.
Well.
I got lost. I couldn't find the doorknob.
Charlie's with the police. I'm sure he'll want to help you.
Is this a bust?
I'll say. Come on. I'm going to take you next door for some questioning.
But what if I don't know the answers?
You'll know the answers. What a night.
And that's the story of those kids. It's now 12 o'clock. Do you know where your children are? And this just in, correct?
Yes, I do.
It's a minute past midnight, young lady.
So what are you going to do, spank me? I get this heartbreaking message about you being in jail. Another lie?
Donna, I don't know how to tell you this, but I was arrested for assaulting a woman at the Bailey Hotel.
Assaulting a woman?
I'm innocent, I swear. She assaulted me.
I would have thought a man like you would have enjoyed that.
What kind of guy is that, A liar? A sneak? I didn't know you were the new high school nurse. Danny's been running around here for 3 days talking about the new school nurse, hoping I'd take an interest. Only I thought that I had met an uptown Johns Hopkins woman who was not so quick in telling me what she's doing now.
Oh, Bill, you never gave me a chance. You're so busy trying to look at the boats in the marina or telling me about some psychological trauma from jury duty. And what were you doing at the Bailey Hotel?
A girl named Sally Palmer told me that Jim and Danny checked in there.
Oh, Bill, Sally Palmer is Jim's old girlfriend. She's been giving Danny a hard time all night. You've got to trust her more, Bill. She's a good girl.
Yeah. You know, today, my daughter said something to me that should have made me the happiest man on earth. Instead, it just chilled me to the bone.
What was that?
She said, Dad, a guy asked me out, and I know you'll like him. Because he's just like you. And I thought about it. And suddenly 10 years of being a single man and a father came crashing together like two locomotives on the same track. And I was right between them.
I was too, Bill. And so was Danny.
What is that?
Shh, shh, shh.
Sally Palmer is hiding in the bushes.
What? Oh, I swear, that girl, I'm gonna give her a piece of my mind.
No, wait, wait. I got a plan.
Go away, go away.
Talk to your dad about the car?
No. I better handle it. You don't know how he can get.
He'll try to kiss her. I know it.
I should hope so.
At least he plays football. I think I just lost my baby.
You didn't lose her, Bill. You just found her.
God, the kid's performing a tonsillectomy. Are they ever coming up for air?
Maybe.
Oh, my father. I can't believe him.
Well, I guess I better take off. You want to go to a movie or something tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yeah?
If my father let me out of the house again.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Thanks for calling me.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I'll call you.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, wait, I forgot my van keys.
Oh, I'll get them.
Hey, the van keys.
I drove it over. My neighbor followed me. Dad.
Huh? Hi, sweetie.
Jim needs his van keys.
Keys? Here they are. Nothing happened to my car, right?
Well, sir, to be honest.
What? To be honest, what?
When we pulled into the lot, some idiot in a car pulled in too close to us, and when he opened the door, he scratched a Corvette. I'm really sorry, and I'll be happy to pay for it.
Oh, just a scratch, is that all? Oh, you shouldn't let such minor things upset you, Jim. Next time, be more careful.
Yes, sir.
Did you say next time? See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Good night.
Bye.
You had such an exciting evening that you want to go out again tomorrow? What did you do?
Nothing. What did you do?
Nothing.
Well, I guess I'll go to bed now.
I like him. I like him a lot. Have a good time tomorrow.
Daddy! Daddy, I love you.
Well, if you don't have anything left on your busy schedule for the night, how about some ice cream with your old man?
Sure. Dad, I had the best time tonight.
You know, I did too. Remember that nurse Thompson you wanted me to meet? Well,